Crikey. Have they finished? Think so. I've not got my microphone plugged in because I'm a bit tipsy. But I need to do my comic reviews, so I've been out for most of the day. Might have had one or two or five or six drinks, so we'll see how this goes. So I do apologize if the sound's not any good, but what can you do when you've been out? What am I doing? Oh yeah, looking at the at the reviews for this week. So first up is one that came out, I think, last week or the week before. And it sold out at my shop, so I had to order it on eBay. So this is Spectrograph number 2 by James Tynion and Christian Ward. This is basically a 21st century version of a haunted house tale. This occult, really rich guy who's heavily into the occult, he invents this machine called a spectrograph that he hopes can capture a ghost. And this woman volunteers to go into this house, and she tricks this other woman who's the estate agent to give her the keys for the house. And so the story develops from that, and ghosts appear. But I don't really want to say more about it. I did mention last month with the first issue that was quite a an upsetting bit in it for me personally as a parent about this baby that got abandoned, and that raises its head again in this issue, and I still struggle with it. So that puts me out a bit because I'm like, oh, that poor baby. I'm really worried about the baby. And James Tynion, the bastard, he knows that that is why he's doing it, because it's always in the back of your mind. Is she gonna escape the estate agent? Is she gonna escape the haunted house in time to save her baby? But yeah, art is really gorgeous by Christian Ward. Really nice color, nice use of colors and layouts. Just very, very fresh. It's James Tynion, it's Christian Ward at the top of the game, both of them at the top of the games creatively. It's a pleasure to read. Distillery is fast becoming one of my favourite comic companies. Gorgeous, perfect bound, oversized European album format, 48 pages of art and story. 9.5 out of 10 for that one. Oh, where's all my other comics gone? Shit. Here we go. And then we have a few more from a few weeks ago. So I've got Free Agents number one. I got the alternate cover by Kevin Maguire. So it's written by Fabian Nicasia and Kurt Busiek. Artwork by Stephen Mooney. Art's okay, it's fine. But it's 40 pages of story. So I expected like it to be paced a lot more, less frenetic and frantic as it is. They put a shitload of stuff in this, and to be honest, I think they could have maybe just uncluttered it a bit. Because what I got from it, the aliens who've come to Earth and are being chased by other aliens. But for the life of me, I can't remember any of the names or who they were. Some of the characters look so similar that I had trouble telling them apart. I don't know if I liked it or if I didn't like it. It really is. This is a conundrum, so I can't even give it a mark. I'm going to give this a question mark out of 10. All I can say is try it, make up your mind for yourself, but it's a puzzle. I might try issue 2 to see if they explain some of the. There's so much info dumping in this. If they'll sift through that and just make it a bit more palatable and understandable. So there we go. And then this came from a few weeks ago, because I was going to stop it, but I've decided to carry on with it now. Dan Mora, it's Mark Waid, so I might as well. It's world's finest. Number 28. Great cover, beautiful artwork. After reading Absolute Power, I knew I had to carry on with this. It's okay. The story's okay. It's not one of the stronger World's Finest stories. I'd give the story 7, 6.5, 7 out of 10. Artwork, 8.5 out of 10. So I am carrying on with it. And then we have the next installment of Geiger, number 4. This is fast becoming one of the best comics out there. Beautiful artwork, gorgeous cardstock cover, great artwork, great story by Geoff Johns. It's become basically an apocalyptic western. Somebody's kidnapped Geiger's dog, and he is out to rescue his dog, and he comes across this society who aren't very nice. They basically like to eat other people, and lots of shenanigans happen. But there's this other guy who's like masterminding all this of the kidnapping of his dog. He's basically got his dog to ransom, and he basically finds Geiger's Achilles heel. And yeah, I don't really, again, I don't want to give too much away, but it's very satisfying. It's a very breezy read in places. Artwork is beautiful, so that'll slow you down a bit if you want to just like soak in how detailed the artwork is. Even the cover is just really nice in its simplicity. But it looks simple, but when we look at more and more, there's so much detail in there. Yeah, it's a constant 9 out of 10. And this one is Falling in Love on the Path to Hell, Book 2, by Andy Duggan and Gary Brown. Great cover. So as last month, they've basically ended up in limbo, this samurai, this female samurai and this gunslinger, and they're met by this guy. I don't know if he's a Sikh or something like that. He basically tells them to follow him because he arrived at this island which is basically limbo, and they basically have to they end up having to pull together, team together, to fight these creatures. If they don't fight these creatures, they die. And the gunslinger says, oh, no, I refuse. And so, well, you don't fight them, you fight us. And so it ends on that cliffhanger. What's weird is they don't put any credits in it. So I had to find it by looking in the indices. So yes, it's by Jerry Duggan and Brown. Oh God, don't film when you're pissed. And Gary Brown. Yeah, I had to look in the indices for that. But apart from that, yeah, it's a good read. It's slowly, it's not really letting you know much about any of the characters from the initial setup on the first issue. But the artwork's lovely. It's got almost like Sean Murphy who did White Knight, and a bit like him. I must have buggered his name because I'm so, my head's just mashed. And Dennis Cohen, a bit like if those two met together. And yeah, it's a good rollicking old-fashioned adventure. So, rollicking. I'd give this a 7.5 out of 10. And is there any more from Image? Yeah, one more Image one. And that is Ain't No Grave number 3 by Scotty Young and Jorge Corona. So as we explained last issue, McKenna, I think it's set in purgatory. So she's dying of an illness. I don't know if it's consumption or something like that. Artwork, as per usual, is beautiful. And so she decides to find, I think it's either the devil or death, to claim her life back. So it's very much a weird western. So if you imagine like Jonah Hex when Joe Lansdale did it, it's got that kind of like big supernatural elements. So she's like gambling against demons and people like that. The artwork is jaw-droppingly good. The story, it's not meandering, but it's very much of a skeleton story. There's not much meat on its bones, but it is worth it for the artwork, and it's not badly written by any means. But to say it's only a 5-issue comic, I expect a bit more in the story. So for that reason, I'm going to give it a 7 out of 5. But it's a beautiful, beautiful comic, and I will see it to the end. And I've just got one Marvel comic, and this is a comic I said I wouldn't get. But I'm shallow, and I'm a sucker for new X-Men launches. So my two favourite Marvel teams are X-Men Ones and Defenders. Ever since the early 80s for X-Men, 70s for the Defenders. So as soon as I saw this, I'll have a look in the shop. I didn't order it, I'll have a look in the shop. It's Stegman artwork, I do like Stegman. And I'm pleased I picked it up. I am going to carry on with it for a bit, see how it goes. The artwork's lovely, but there's some of it's a bit smudgy. It's like you can see like his pencils or however he did it. And it's very smudgy on some of the pages. But the writing, I don't know about what it is with Jed MacKay, seems to be on team books, or if he's focused on more than one character. There's a lot of clunky writing, a lot of exposition. There's like 2 pages that are fighting, and it's like this reams and reams, these paragraphs of info dumping about what they've been doing in the interim, explaining why Krakoa's not around and who these people are, blah, blah, blah. And this is why they're fighting, and I'm thinking, fight will take a few seconds, but it takes longer than that to read it. There's no way you'd be saying all that while you're fighting somebody. So that pulled me out. It's like, it felt very early 90s. So the story I'd give 6 out of 5. Artwork, 8 out of 10. Not 6 out of 5, 6 out of 10. Artwork, I'd give 8 out of 10. But I'm going to give a few issues, see how it goes, and then make up my mind. I am looking forward to the Gail Simone one. And speaking of Gail Simone, she is. Do you like that link? That was really cool. Speaking of Gail Simone, she did Superman Action Comics in the main story, and Rainbow Rowell, and oh fuck, Eddie Barros did the artwork, by the way, in the Gail Simone one, and Rainbow Rowell, and Sian Tormey does the artwork on the backup strip. So the main strip is a retro one. I think it's meant to be like in the late, set in like the late 60s, 70s. So I found that a bit of an odd choice. I can understand him doing like a look at his early years, but his early years, but in a different, you know, like 30, 40 years ago, it just feels a bit strange. So I don't know. And I didn't, again, a very old-fashioned writing. There's a lot of speech bubbles, not speech bubbles, but thought bubbles in it. And there's a lot of dialogue boxes explaining what they were actually doing. So again, that threw me out. So I don't know if I liked it or not. Artwork's gorgeous by Eddie Barros. He's a really nice art. But story, I think he expects more from a Gail Simone story. So I give the story 6 and the artwork 8. Backup strip by Rainbow Rowell was much more enjoyable, actually. And I can't believe I'm saying that, but there we go. And the artwork's really nice and clean by Contomi. And it's much more of a contemporary Superman story. So they kind of like clash against each other because they're different settings. I just don't understand why this is done in like a. I understand it being in his past, but why do it so long his past? Because that could mean Superman now would be about 60. So I just don't understand that. So yeah, I just don't know. So 6 out of 10 for the main story, 7 out of 10 for the backup. And then we have Green Lantern by Jeffrey Adams, and who's the artist? Fernando Passarin. Really nice artwork. So this ties into Absolute Power, but what I love about how they've done Absolute Power, they've been building this into the storyline for a long time, so you're not suddenly dropped in it like they have been doing with Bloodhunt. This has been threaded into the storyline in a very organic way. Gorgeous cover, by the way. And yeah, I'm loving the story. I didn't like Jeremy Adams at all on Flash, but on Green Lantern, he's killing it now. And it's got the Absolute Power storyline going on, but it's got his other storyline that's been building up as well, going on alongside it. And it doesn't feel clunky at all or out of place. I'm really enjoying it. And there was this backup story focused on the Big Bad, whose name I can't remember. I'm not going to look into it. I think it's Greg Guggenheim doing the writing on that one. Could be wrong. Yeah, that was all right. But the main story, 8 out of 10. And then my battery's running low, I think. Batman Robin, number 11 by Williamson. And Jose Ferreira on, is it Juan Ferreira? I think I'm just inventing first names for them. Juan Ferreira, that's it. Who, I think he did the spine-tingling Spider-Man, was it? With Salman Ahmed, or whatever he pronounces his surname. So yeah, so this is Batman Robin on Dinosaur Island, and Bane's on Dinosaur Island as well. So yeah, it's fun. Good fun comic. What it's this is like the breath of fresh air. It's not as po-faced and serious as the other Batman titles. Yeah, 8 out of 10. Good fun. And then we have Gotham by Gaslight, Kryptonian Age number 2. Love that cover. This is by Andy Diggle, Leandro Fernandez, gorgeous artwork by Dave, colouring by Dave Stewart. So this is delving more into the story, and it's got some more alternate takes on different members of the DC universe, and there's a fantastic bit of the later on reveals a certain Amazonian, and I won't show you, and there's a good version of Constantine in here as well. Yeah, I'm just really enjoying this. This is such a blast to read. 30 pages of story for $4.99, you can't complain at that. Beautiful, beautiful artwork. It's compelling, it's fun. I'm really loving this Elseworlds title. And yeah, 9 out of 10. And this is going to get 10 out of 10, this one. And this is my favourite cover as well. Conan, Savage Souls Conan's Smell of the Week, as pop culture philosophers would say. And $6.99, so bargain of the week as well, because you get 64 pages or so in it. And you get a big story by Kerry Nod, the artwork by Kerry Nod on this is beautiful. Don't know if you can see it. I'm going to regret doing this in this state that I'm in. But yeah, really, really nice. So basically, Conan gets bitten by somebody and something happens to him and he becomes another type of creature and he has to find a cure. And that's what happens. So you'll have to find out, but it's got action, it's got fantastic dialogue, and it's got a laugh out loud. I love the ending on it. There's a really laugh out loud ending to it. It's just fun, and there's a prose story and an interview with one of the common writers of the novels, and the Solomon Kane story carries on. It's a really good package, so it is going to get 10 out of 10. It's not had a great back cover as well. It's not had a bad issue. This is the one of the most fun comics on the stands, and one of the most best value comics as well. So, why didn't I do that all the time? Why was I holding it up when I could have had it like this? You know, I'm... don't drink, kids. That's all I can say. Don't drink. It's okay to drink coffee like this. Just saying no to cider and other booze. But yeah, that's all, I think. Oh, one other thing. No, that's it. So, there is no moral of the story because it's not a story. I was just doing a review. So, yeah, that's everything. I'm going to do, if I sober up, I might do another one in a bit. If not, I'll do one tomorrow where I look at a special 2000 AD issue. Okay, bye. Bye.